Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we'll start to make this body for revolving centre. It consists of a number 2 Morse taper, but you can make it as a number 3, and a bore that holds a bearing. So before we start to make this, we need a plan. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Whenever I do anything in the lathe, I always make a rough sketch of what I'm making. These are the dimensions of the part we're making today. I have problem getting in with my tool on some of the centres. So if this was a bar I'm turning, on this particular one, I could get in with the tool, but as soon as I get to that diameter, the tool hits the centre and I can't swivel the tool round at a different angle because it alters the cutting edge. So you might think, oh, I'll use a smaller centre. There's the smaller centre. There's the bar. With this tool, it's a 10mm shank. That won't go in the gap between the bar I want to turn and the revolving centre. So what I need is a centre that sticks out further so I can get that tool in, but not as big as this one. And that's what I'm going to do today, make a new revolving centre. First thing, I've purchased three bearings. Now these three bearings are 8mm bore, 22mm diameter, 7mm wide. So they'll be stacked up to hold the centre. I've purchased bearings that have seals on each side, so I won't have any problem with swarf or suds getting into the bearing. I'll also use this washer. I'll use that as a cover, and it just wants the diameter reducing. So that's the bearings and the cover sorted. And for the steel, I'll use this piece of steel, which is about 30mm diameter, and it needs to be around 115mm long. Now, on making this part, there are two ways you could do it. If you start it by doing this end, do all this work on this, when you take it out the chuck, turn it round to do the other end, you have a problem in how do you know that this is running true to your finished taper. So if you think of the finished job, normally a taper you should be able to run between centres and it should be true. So that's the way I'm going to do this. I'm going to put this between centres, so I'll drill a centre hole in this part, a centre hole in this before we machine it out, put it between centres and then machine this taper to get a good fit. I'm doing a number 2, but it can be a number 3 if your tailstock's number 3. That way, if you have a problem getting the right taper, you can have 2 or 3 goes at it, you're just moving further along the bar, and you can still finish this off on the end of the bar. So if you start with the taper first, put the part between centres, machine the taper, get that right, then you can hold the taper in your headstock by using
a Morse taper adapter,
and you know whatever you do on this end will be running true to the taper. That's the most important thing, is that the taper is true to the bearing bore. I've placed it in the forge or chuck, and I've just clocked it up true.
That's running, we need 3 or 4 tenths of a thou. And the next thing we want to do is face it off and centre drill it.
Okay, so I've done that. Now I need to turn it round and do the other side. So what I'm going to do is just undo the jaw where the label is, and the jaw in front, take the bar out, turn it round, put that back in, tighten the jaw in front, on where the label is, I'll just check the run out on that. I'll just put the dial indicator on there. I haven't clocked this up, and it's running out less than a thou. just show you the setup. And what I'm doing is using this as a guide. It's roughly the same length as this bar, so there won't be much difference in the taper. But what I'm doing is just running a dial indicator with a flat bottom along the taper. This is in thous, 0 to 10 is a thou. So I've got a couple of thou difference. I'm leaving it at that because being slightly shorter than the bar, I know I'll have to alter it anyway, but it is a good starting point. This end I fitted a number 2 Morse taper with a female centre, and in the centre I've put a ball bearing. The idea of this is you can use a standard centre, but you're putting more load on one side of the centre hole. When you're offsetting it, you're actually pulling it out of centre in the hole. By putting a ball bearing in, the centre will run true, the centre in the part will run true to the ball bearing, and the centre here will run true to the ball bearing. So you're sort of pivoting on the ball rather than using a fixed taper. So if you put a normal centre in, what you're doing is bending that like that. So you're exaggerated, you're running on half of your centre, and it will put marks on the centre. I think that's where I've got mine from. The edge here, dig into the centre, so it's running on the point on the inside and the edge on the outside. By using a ball, having a spherical surface, it doesn't matter where you are, it will locate itself true on the ball. That's the theory behind it. All you have to remember is when you undo your centres, that ball will fall out. On this lathe, the zero marks are on the back here of the tailstock. And this is one of the screws. And there's one on the opposite side. And it pulls the tailstock top towards you or away from you, depending on which ones you tighten. So I've set that up roughly. Now I'll put the part in. So on this end, I've fitted a carrier. That goes on to the centre. And on this end, ball goes in there, that goes on there. This doesn't need any oil on this end because as the headstock moves around, you can see the centre goes round with it, so there's no wear or movement in the centre on this end. This is the only end that's going to take any movement or friction, so you just need to keep your eye on the bearing that it's not getting hot. I've just marked the red line where the taper I want to end. So I'll machine it till this taper gets to there. Then I'll measure the diameter, see how much I have to lift to come off. Now I've machined all this so far with that ball bearing. I'll have to revert back to my centre because my tool now is not far away from the outside of this. I can't go any smaller than this diameter, and I need to still go down about another 5 mm. So I'll put my centre back in. Okay, I've just spread a small amount of micrometer blue along the taper, and I'm using this as a gauge. This is a number 2 internal Morse taper to a 3 external. And what I need to do is put this inside, turn it, remove it and see where it's rubbing. And immediately you can see it's touching more on this end than it is on this end. So that means I need more material off this. So what I have to do is pull the tailstock away like that. So I'm cutting more off this side. When you get down to this sort of level, be careful, because if you say take 5 or 6 thou off the diameter, being that it's such a shallow angle, the Morse taper will probably move up 20 or 30 thou. It's not in proportion to what you take off. So be careful, because you might think, oh, I'll take 20 thou off there, all of a sudden this will jump up to there. So do it in small amounts. I've adjusted the tailstock, pulled it back that way, so I'm taking less off here, more off this end. Okay, I've just tried it again with the micrometer blue on, and as you can see, it's not touching this end that much. It's touching at the bottom more. So I want to move it a few tenths so that I take more off the bottom. So to do that, I've set up the dial indicator. What I'll do is tighten up the grub screw on one side and slacken it off on the other. Now that's moved it a thou, so I'll move it back. So I'm taking half a thou more off. Lock it up. If you use a dial indicator, you can control the amount you're moving it. Without a dial indicator, you're just guessing. I'll leave that at that setting and take another cut. I've also changed my tool to try and get a better finish. So I'm back to the old problem. The tool's touching the centre and I still need to go in further. Here I've reduced the diameter, because as you get closer to the finish size, you need the end will start appearing in here. As you can see, it's got a diameter there and it's got a flat there. So you could end up with the diameter hitting the flat. So I've reduced the diameter. Because I'm going to have a 9mm hole in, this will go anyway when I finish it. I finished cutting the taper. So when the taper goes in, I've still got a small amount here spare, so if I need to I can redo it. But you can see on this end that the centre is now halfway in the middle of the slot. So that means when this is in the tailstock or in a machine, tailstock will eject it. If this was this face here, doesn't show in the centre of that, it won't eject. That fits on there okay. If I just rub it, I haven't put any marking blue on here. You can see it's touching at this end, it's touching down. You can see down there and it's touching there. It's probably be a bit harder on the bottom than it is on the top. So I just polish this a bit more off at the bottom. It's that fine amount now that adjusting it, I'll probably go too far. So I've got my polishing stick. Put that in, it's locked in. In fact, I'll need a drift to get that out. So that's okay for a taper. So I put the part in the four-jaw chuck and I've clocked it up to within a tenth. So what I'm going to do now with the centre drill, I'll just drill this out and then put an 8mm drill through the length of this. So I've drilled my 8mm hole, which goes down to nearly where the chuck is, and it's taking the pip off the end. As you can see, when that goes in there, you can still see the end of the Morse taper in the slot. So if you put a drift through, you can still get the Morse taper off. This recess is just to fit a washer in there, stop swarf and dirt getting in, so you can make it whatever diameter you like. But you need to control the depth, because by the time you've stacked your bearings up in here, the bearings should just come over the end of that lip and leave enough space for the washer thickness. And this recess here is for another washer. We'll make an 11mm by 2mm washer to go in this, and this is an 8mm bore. So what will happen in here, you'll have a washer in this end with a
cap head through, 5mm cap head. You need to turn the head of the cap head down to fit this 8mm. That tightens up on all the bearings and pulls the centre in. That's the setup for this. So now I want to drill the 8mm hole straight through, bore this out then to 22mm by about 23mm deep. So we've drilled an 8mm hole straight through. Now I've just faced that off to 30mm because the bearings will take up 23mm. Then we've got a washer inside, so it leaves me a few mil to spare on the end. The last thing I want to do is 20mm hole straight through and come out the back here. So I've got to allow. Now I've just put a half inch end mill in the Jacob's chuck. Use that as a thickness just to set my zero on the end of the tailstock. So I want to go in 23mm with that. So now I've got a half inch hole, 23mm deep, and the half inch will allow me to put my boring bar in. I set my boring bar up and dial indicator. So when I go into the bore, I can go to zero on the dial indicator and I know I'm at the depth I need. So as I come down, I hit the dial indicator. I go around to one as a warning and then I stop at the second zero. I find if I've just got one rotation, it's gone like that before you know it and you've ploughed into your face. So at least I've got one rotation to react, and then by the time it comes up to the zero on the second one, that's the depth. Just finished off the bore. I've had to revert to an old boring tool to try and get a decent finish. It's still a rough finish, but this bearing now just starts to go in, and this material's still hot, so I'm hoping it will shrink down a bit when it cools down. Just machined a little recess on the end. It's about 25.5mm diameter and 2mm deep. That's for the washer to go in. I'll just have to take some off the outside of this washer.
Well, I think that's enough for today. We'll finish making this project off in part two. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.